Saki. Isn't retirement great?
Yeah, Nev, it's nice and peaceful out here in the country.
Yeah, it's so peaceful, I think I'll take a nap. How do you make a tissue dance? You put a little boogie in it. How do you get a one-armed Pollock out of a tree? You wave at him. What did the cannibal get when he was late for dinner? The cold shoulder.
Evan, wake up.
What, Saki?
Evan, you can't stop telling jokes. You got a disease called jokeritis.
Jokeritis? What's the cure?
You're gonna have to fly back to Staten Island to do a show.
Okay.
Let's go.
Wait up, Saki.
Staten Island Comedy Show with tonight's guests, Angela Corcia, Natalie Peri, Miranda Tiffany, Jen Elyse Feldman, Francesca DiPaola, announcer, bodybuilder Bob, Marty Beck, Artem Kulakov, Jason Soul, Iorgo Papoutsas,
Yurgo.
Lisa Harman, Carrie Graverson, Frank Cintula, Joe Romby Jr.,
you,
Andrew Lenning, Paula Herveaux, and Maureen Wojciechowski. And now, take it away, Freddy Concha!
It's the Staten Island Comedy Show with your host, Nevin Cummings!
Yeah! Welcome everyone to the Staten Island Comedy Show!
We're
gonna have a great show for you tonight, so stay tuned. We got a musical guest tonight.
Musical guest?
Musical guest, Freddie.
Yeah, musical
Natalie
guest.
Perry's on the in the
Natalie
house tonight.
Perry,
Natalie
get out!
Natalie Perry's down now.
Live on Staten Island.
Live on Staten Island. Natalie Perry, actress, singer. We
wow.
have four beautiful co-hosts tonight.
Beautiful.
Staten Island. We,
that ain't the word.
It's unprecedented here on the Staten Island Comedy Show.
Well, it's
well, you know, it's just, but we have comedians. We have a whole lot of comedians.
Oh,
a lot of
we
fun
have
tonight.
Comedians.
Right here on the Staten Island Comedy Show.
Yeah, even the audience.
Even the audience is here, which is unusual.
Yeah.
But you know what, Freddie?
What?
I was at this banquet the other day, and my dentures were hurting me.
Get
so
out.
This guy sitting next to me reaches in his pocket and gives me a pair of dentures. So I tried them on, they were too tight. So he reached in his other pocket and pulled out another pair of dentures. And I tried them on, and they fit perfectly. So I used them the whole night, and at the end of the night, I went to give it back to him, and I told him, thank God I was sitting next to a dentist. And he said, I'm not a dentist, I'm an undertaker.
Woo! An undertaker!
I tell you, Fred, I had to give the teeth back, too. But anyway, we're going to have a great show for you tonight. Staten Island.
All right.
Manhattan, Brooklyn, the whole country. And Freddy Coscia, take us away. Angela Corcia. Tonight we have four beautiful co-hosts tonight.
Yes.
Angela Corcia, our regular. Miranda Tiffany is another one. And she's our regular, too.
I don't know if anybody can see me, but hi. Here I am. Here I am.
They can see you. Jen Feldman.
Feldman! Yeah!
And Francesca DiPaola.
DiPaola! DiPaola Creed.
So we have
oh, no, that's...
We have a lot of guests.
That's
Bodybuilder Bob, you look very Chippendale-ish.
Why, thank you.
Right. Chippendale.
1970 Chippendale calendar.
Wow.
I'm the last.
You're the last of the survivors.
Last of the survivors. Well, give me...
Yeah.
All right. There you go.
Wow.
Wow.
Okay, but moving right along. Angela, we just got a lot of guests tonight here.
We do.
And our first guest.
Our first guest here
is Pauline Herveaux.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah. That mic's right there is fine. Just speak up, and all of Staten Island and the country will hear you.
Awesome. Well, thank you for having me. Very happy to be here.
Okay. So, Pauline, where are you from?
I am a proud, born and raised, first generation native here from Staten Island. Hibernia, so
all right.
Very proud of the
yeah.
And do you have any projects going on?
Well, I'm currently an event planner and I do stand-up comedy as my passion. Actually, following the show, I run over to my night job, which is the open mic at Hashtag, which gets about 70 people every Monday. It's a free show, so if you have any musical or comedy friends that want a free stage time, just send them over my way to Vancouver Street. And other than that, I do monthly showcases, flying out to Ohio at the end of the month to work with one of Snoop Dogg's friends and Shaquille O'Neal's comedian friends. And aside from that, I'll be at Caroline's on August 24th, Monday.
Oh, great. So who's your favorite? Who's your favorite comic?
Oh, God, I have a few. Obviously, I love George Carlin. One of the comedians I'm opening for in Ohio is a woman named April Macy, who's worked with Howard Stern and, like I said, with Snoop Dogg. So she's been a big inspiration for me. So just having that come full circle to open for her later this month is a really big deal for me.
Oh, great. Okay, so you have an act for us tonight?
Yeah, okay. Do a few minutes.
Yeah.
Oh,
great.
Yeah.
Can you guys hear me on this now? Is that good?
All right. Well, as I told you guys already, I am from Staten Island, born and raised, and we do have a little bit of a tough cookie reputation. I feel like if you're from Staten Island, it kind of hardens you, and we're not afraid of anything, unless you're a young white female, and then you're only afraid of Dunkin' Donuts running out of your free iced latte flavor, your favorite one. That's horrible. Yeah. Actually, there's one thing I am afraid of on Staten Island, and only if you're from here will you understand this, and it's the real... toughest, you can go to any neighborhood, anybody that said they're in the mob, a gang, it doesn't matter. The toughest organisms on this island are the turkeys. I don't know if anybody's encountered any of the Staten Island turkeys by the mental hospital, which is kind of cruelly ironic in itself. I can only imagine patients not taking their medication. Doc, I see the turkeys again. I see them. Shoot them up. It's kind of terrible. It's true, though. What else? When I date guys on Staten Island, I like to tell them I'm into role-playing. But when I say that, I say that I like to play I'll be the pothole, you'll be the Nissan Altima, because if you hit me once, I'll mess up your entire life. I know. I'm really, really good at being single. I noticed I'm also equally as not talented at being in a relationship, because I'm still on that, like, trying to find that healthy balance between being crazy and not being completely crazy. I noticed this happened recently when I was driving with my boyfriend in the car, and this rude woman interrupts us out of nowhere and says, at the next light, make a left. So I screamed out, you don't tell my man what to do. So we had to have Siri's voice changed to a male Australian, because she likes to overstep her boundaries sometimes. Dating's a little weird like that. I also don't let him buy Sour Lee cakes or Little Debbie's, because what is it, a bakery or a whorehouse? I don't know. I'm not sure. I'm not having any of those ladies in my fridge. I don't know. Dating on Staten Island's hard when you are basically a real-life 5'10" Amazon version of Princess Peach, and all the men around you are like Super Mario. It's really not fun. They're just jumping around on mushrooms trying to power up. I'm just trying not to get stolen by a gorilla. But there's a fascinating thing I've noticed about the young men here on Staten Island, and it's an epidemic, if you will. And I'm not talking about heroin. I'm not talking about EDM music. I'm talking about these tribal markings that you'll see on their bodies. You've seen these tribal tattoos? Mm-hmm. Now, I wonder, though, like, they're third-generation Italian-Americans. What tribe are they from? Like, the Huguenots? I don't know. Is that a tribe? It's weird to me, too, though, because, like, these things that they'll get on their bodies, like, are very ambiguous to me because they'll get, like, loyalty and respect while they're cheating on their girlfriend at the shore. And I'm like, dude, you can lie to me all you want. Like, you're going to lie to your bicep? You worship those things. Like, you are a living billboard of lies. Like, this is very, I don't know. It's weird to me, too, because the people you don't see with tribal tattoos, like the Native Americans, all two of them that are left, they don't have them. And because if they did and you saw them, it would be kind of depressing because what would they get to represent their struggles? Like, rest in peace, 98% of us. Oh. And there's like an eagle crying into a cornfield. I don't know. Oh. Whatever. They don't have to pay for college, at least. You put your Native American on a college application, they just send you an athletic scholarship. You don't even play sports. We don't care. We knew that you guys knew how to hunt. There you go. I don't know. A lot of things are weird like that. I think it's 2015, and we should have time travel by now. Anybody else like a little pissed about that? We have the Apple Watch, but we can't travel through time. Whatever. I do think it's interesting, though, that men are from Mars and women are from Venus, because if you ask a man what he would do if he could travel back in time, they have the coolest answers ever. They're like, I would go fight with George Washington. I would befriend the dinosaurs. Because who wouldn't? That's a smart answer. If you ask a woman, however, if she was given the chance to time travel, 110% of us would probably go back and just unhave sex with certain people. It's like, sure, I could have gotten Hitler into art school, or like I could have stopped that other guy from having sex with the AIDS monkey. Oh, but did you see a couple of the guys I dated after college? It wasn't a very good time for me. So let's hope that when the time comes, the first person to test drive time travel is not a woman, because she'll just ruin everything. Be like, she only went back 2 weeks ago to that Tinder date. This is stupid. I don't know, guys. I'm going to leave you guys with that, though. So I'm Pauline Herveaux. I'll be at Caroline's August 24th, and I'll be in Ohio later this month, but I probably won't see any of you guys there. Thank you guys for having me.
It's killing me.
It's a killer night tonight. Don't you feel the energy?
I feel the energy. Really, I'm super excited.
It's really, I can feel it. Miranda, I can feel it.
I can feel it too. It's intense. Go.
Okay, so our next guest is a singer-songwriter. Her name is Natalie Peri, and she's performing right here on the Staten Island Comedy Show tonight. She's into, she has a series coming out and everything about vampires.
Wow.
On television.
Wow.
So without any further ado.
Further ado.
Natalie Peri, everyone.
Yay. I don't know which me. She's a ghost. She became a ghost.
Show is coming out, and later on, after Natalie's song, we're going to show a roll-in of this of this show, just a little taste of the new show coming out. And we're doing it all over the country. I'm traveling all over the country, and I'm interviewing comics from all over in comedy clubs in all the cities throughout the United States.
Wow, that's awesome.
And we're going to put together this show. It's called the Nevin Cummings Comedy Show, along with the Staten Island Comedy Show. I'm going to cover both coasts. It's going to be L.A. and New York.
In L.A.
Very good.
Yes.
Nice.
Okay. Coast to
coast. Well, awesome. Good for you, Fred.
As soon as Natalie comes out,
Natalie.
We'll to do this. But since Natalie's not here right now, maybe we could have that roll-in of the comedy show. If you have that roll-in. Oh, yeah, and so now this first performer, his name was Marty Burke.
Marty Burke.
Right. He's a Midwestern boy from Iowa. Okay, he now lives in Redondo Beach, California.
Wow.
Now, I filmed Marty Burke in Palm Springs, okay? And Marty is one of the most creative, unique, versatile entertainers that we have today. Marty has totally different shows to choose from, and all the shows have a lot of singers, dancers, comedy, celebrity impersonations, audience participation, good, clean fun. Okay, Marty Burke's been doing this for over 25 years.
Dang.
Okay, and here's a sample, if the roll-in's ready, of Marty Burke.
Yes, most musical historians will tell you that Bill Haley and his Comets was the very first rock and roll band. I'm afraid I don't agree with that. I think the very first rock and roll band was Tarzan and Jane. What was her monkey's name? Cheetah. Cheetah, yes, everybody knows Cheetah. But not everybody knows that Cheetah played the drums. And Jean was a sexy backup singer like Lorraine. And Tarzan was the lead singer, and he played the guitar, and he had a little nickname, and it was Guitarzan. So now we found
Yay! All right. Natalie.
So we have Natalie Peri is going to perform for us tonight right here on the Staten Island Comedy Show. Natalie Peri and Freddie and the Shooting Star Band, Maya Rasabi.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
For our
thank
next.
Thank you, Natalie.
Meyer.
Meyer and Freddie.
Freddie.
Meyer.
Great job, you guys. Yeah,
that was great. That was so they're going to come back later.
Oh, good.
Yay. Okay, they're going to come back a little later to do another song.
Wonderful.
But
in the meantime,
we have another guest.
We have another guest.
We're not
going to
stop here now.
No.
This show is going to go on forever.
Full speed ahead.
There's no time for stopping.
And our next guest, Angelina
Corcia. Our next guest, Nevin Cummings, is Andrew Lenning.
Hello,
Andrew.
How are you guys today?
Good.
I love the place.
Thank you very much. You know, you like it? You're from Staten Island?
My mom used to tell me that I was found in a desert in Roswell, New Mexico in 1949.
Wow.
My head was this big when I was born. So,
My God.
I have some psychological issues.
Oh, my gosh. How long have you been a comedian?
I've been doing comedy for about 6 months, 5 or 6 months.
Oh, you're a newbie. Breaking in, huh?
Yeah. Breaking in.
Good job. High five.
Thank you.
Good job.
That was
wow.
A good high five, too.
That was strong.
Yeah.
You got a, wow, okay.
I'm trying to just get the energy going.
All right. That was good. Where can we find you?
You could find me on Instagram. My handle there is Why Is This Sticky?
That's great. Yeah. That's great.
That is
great.
It's amazing.
Okay.
I don't have that many projects besides fixing up my dad's basement because I moved back into it.
Okay.
That's the only real project I'm not going on. Where,
okay.
So, who's your favorite comic?
You know what? Being new in comedy, a lot of up and comers. I like seeing the energy. I like seeing guys like Frank Cintula here. He's been doing comedy for a very short time. Is killing it right now. So I'm a lot of newcomers. If I had to pick one, though, Louis C.K. He's a genius.
Yeah.
He's an absolute genius.
A lot of people pick him.
Yeah, they do.
Really good. Yeah.
All right, well, do you
the
have
Staten
a...
Staten Island Comedy Show choice.
That's right. Yeah. The people's choice.
The people's choice.
The bold choice. Absolutely.
All right. Well, do you have a...
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
I am very happy to be here because it's my first time on stage in front of a camera since I filmed the movie Powder. I was the lead role in that.
Thought you looked familiar.
yeah. Don't make fun of me though, because I'll make all the mic stands levitate and like smash through the production window. I went to Burger King today, and they say that their slogan is "Have it your way," but they get really angry every time I ask them for 47 free cheeseburgers, and they throw me right out of their restaurant. That's a ba-dum chit joke too. I do eat. I eat when I'm depressed and like stressed out. I ordered sushi recently, and when I ordered it, I thought I ordered a good amount of sushi, like an acceptable amount of sushi for one adult male to consume in a day. But when I got the bag into my kitchen and opened it, it had 8 sets of utensils in it. And I'm depressed. Like, I already feel like a piece of garbage. You just made me feel 800% worse because apparently I'm eating for 8 morbidly depressed people now. Like, I start thinking to myself, how much soy sauce would I have to drink to kill myself? Like, how much to have a stroke? Like, how much? Well, I think the 12 containers that you gave me would be a good start. And while I'm working on the stroke, I'll take this tennis ball of wasabi that you gave me and rub it in my eyes to make sure that the destruction of my ego is complete. You know what? I think that if you were to sum up my life up to this point in a word, unfortunately, that word might be regret. Like, I regret things like the sushi incident. I regret going to college. Anybody go to college here? College? Here's a fun fact. I paid off half of my student loans, and I still owe $30,000 on an economics degree that I don't use. That's a sad irony that I have to live with every single day of my life, that the course of study that I took should have taught me that I was making a terrible financial decision. And instead of learning that, I learned how much coke I could do and not overdose. Like, I'm serious. Listen, that is the biggest regret of my life. I was using cocaine during a real crucial point in my life when I should have been using Rogaine. And now, instead of hair, I have a police record and a poor reputation. I have a reputation now, you know? My ex Facebook message yesterday, she was like, I just watched the Amy Winehouse documentary, and I thought of you. Hope everything's okay.
Oh my God.
It's like, really, Amy Winehouse? Like, I have some stuff on record, but not Amy Winehouse status, all right? Like, I still got this guy, my upper right bicuspid. I forgot where that joke was going. Next joke. I think I might have the stupidest car accident recorded in human history. Anybody ever been in a stupid car accident that was totally their fault? And not a drunk driving accident either, because that was the bartender's fault, clearly.
No.
You were overserved. I'm just kidding. Don't drink and drive, people. That's stupid.
Yeah.
No, I did something really stupid. You know those big arrows that say, like, don't be in this lane? Yeah, like 50 miles an hour head on into it. And that's a really weird accident to get into because you have to call your insurance company. And you have to be like, hey, Geico? Yeah, I was driving, and there was an object on the road. No. You know the big sign made a light that says don't be in this lane and don't hit this? I hit that. Leave you with this.
Oh, no.
I drive past a sign on the way to work every day. It says, this is our country, not theirs. Where's your flag? And other than the undertones of racism, there's a couple of problems with that sign there. Mainly being the fact that I don't see flags like taking over all of our flagpoles, you know? And even if it was, even if Mexican flags were taking over the flagpoles, I don't see that to be a problem because the Mexican flag is amazing. It's savage. It's an eagle ripping a snake's head off while sitting on a cactus. That is a bad eagle. That's a fierce eagle. Ours is bald. He's fat. He'd probably hire the Mexican eagle to do the work that the American eagle was. You get it. Thank you very much. I'm Andrew Lenning.
like, what?
He left it so soon.
Yeah, I know.
So good.
All right.
I never, like, paid attention to the Mexican flag before. Yeah, now I have to, like, seriously look at the flag. That was, like,
now I'm
going to
really pay attention
so
what it looks
good.
Like, right? It's great. That was great.
Yeah.
Speaking of great, Francesca.
So we have another guest. I'm super excited. I actually met our next guest in the bathroom prior to this, yes. But I will still introduce. So we have here Lisa Harman. Yay! Yay. So, hi, Lisa.
Hi,
so, tell everybody, where are you from?
I'm from Queens, New York.
Hey, hi. Queens. So, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Do you have any upcoming projects or anything that you're performing in currently?
Well, I have a show every Wednesday night at the Phoenix Bar in the Lower East Side. You're all welcome to that.
That's so cool. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. So, I live in Harlem, so I could definitely come hit that up. I'm excited. What time on Wednesdays?
We start We start at 6:30 and we run a couple of hours every Wednesday.
That's great.
It's
great
fun.
For the after work crowd.
Yes.
Yes. And who's your favorite comedian?
Rodney Dangerfield.
Yay! Yay!
That's a good one. All yes.
Right. How long have you been doing comedy?
Before they discovered, you know, Adam, Andrew, and Roswell. I started before then, 1949, before then.
Oh,
1929,
wow.
Since the Depression I started. That's when I started.
Wow, yeah, that's awesome, though. That's awesome.
Cool.
Awesome. And so are you going to give us a few minutes?
I'd love to.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yay. Yay. Give it up for Lisa. Woo!
Drummer before. This is so exciting, you guys. Natalie, what a beautiful voice Natalie has, right?
Yeah.
Oh my God, she was so, she was great. She didn't make a mistake. She was just walking here. Did you see those shoes?
Yeah.
It takes 45 minutes to get across a room with those shoes on. Those shoes are for laying down. They're for laying down. I don't think they're for walking, but good job, Natalie. I'm so happy to be here and tell some jokes, but the only thing is I don't know if it's going to be hard because Freddie's shirt is making me a little seasick, right? Is it just me? I should have taken a Dramamine before I got, if I knew Freddie was going to wear that, I definitely would have. Yeah. See, it's a double dose. Oh, so I'm very thrilled to be here, and thank you so much, Staten Island Comedy. It's so nice to be with people that really love stand-up comedy. It really is. It's great to be here. I was on vacation with my husband last week, and I know that we both gained weight because a couple nights ago we were fooling around, and the cat gouged her own eyeballs out. I know. I know. I went to the sex shop to get a blindfold, and the little girl behind the counter, she's like 21, she says to me, "You need a blindfold for sex." I'm like, "Relax, it's for the cat." Man, it's terrible getting older. I'm getting so much older now, and this whole area here, you guys, this is just like CBGBs. Just like CBGBs. Not much going on now, but we all have a lot of great memories, right? Right, everybody? That's right. We've seen a lot of great punk bands down there back in the day. Isn't that right? We sure did. We sure did. It's terrible getting old. So I go to the salon to get my eyebrow and my upper lip threaded because I can't see anymore to do it. So I was in the chair and the girl was about done. I said to her, "Do me a favor, if you see any stray hairs like around my chin, will you just thread them too? Get them out of there, because I can't see them." She said, "No problem." It took an extra half hour, and they swept under my chair 4 more times. It's terrible getting old. I hate getting old, and everybody hates getting old. Some of my friends are worried about getting sick. Some of them are worried about going broke. And me, I just don't want to end up with those sweaters with the reindeer and the snowmen and all that junk on there. Oh, no! What happened to you? You decided you didn't want to be a woman anymore, just a Hallmark card. That's good enough. That is good enough right now. I will settle for that. I told you guys I'm from Queens, and I don't know if you heard this in the news. A couple of weeks ago, a man in a wheelchair actually robbed a bank in Queens, in my neighborhood. And he actually got away with it. And I just thought to myself, I am not living up to my potential. Right? This guy's in a wheelchair, and he made $2,000 like that in the middle of the afternoon. I would definitely vote for him if he was running for president. Because he's got a can-do attitude, right? But they're so racist. They finally arrested him 3 days later, and I'm pretty sure they're going to put him in jail because he's black. I mean, if he was white, they would have said, thank you for helping us find the holes in our security. We've got a job for you in our insurance company making $50,000 a year, right? I would definitely vote for him. But what I'm doing now is I don't know who I'm voting for in 2016, but what I do is I like to go up to white guys with money and tell them that I'm voting for Hillary. And then I tell them I'm voting for her. When they say why, I say because she's a woman. And then I watch their head explode. It's great. It's great. That's my other hobby besides comedy, is messing with white guys. I loved when Obama ran for office and all the black people said, we're voting for Obama because he's black. And all the white guys were like, what? You don't know anything about Obama. You don't know his policies. You don't know anything. But we know he's not white. That was all they needed to know. And every time you bring up Hillary, somebody in the audience groans and moans, what's, you know, Hillary, oh no, Hillary. I don't know what you're afraid of, you know what I mean? I mean, really, they're already listening to all our phone calls, right? Most of us are half a paycheck away from homelessness. I mean, what do you think Hillary Clinton's going to do to you? We know what she's not going to do for you, right, Bill Clinton? All right, that's the one thing we know. That she doesn't. So I just want to say one last thing. I did go on stage last night behind a young girl, and this girl got on stage and said the funniest thing. She said, I'm sick of these guys that ask you your name and then take you around the dumpster for a BJ. What? So she said, and I was like, they ask you your name? Yeah. He's a keeper. All right, thank you guys. I'm Lisa Harman.
And Miranda, and Bob, everybody on stage. Yeah, yeah. We're really on a roll tonight.
Yeah, we are.
On a roll.
That's great.
On a roll.
Rolling on a river.
So, Jen, our next guest.
Rolling.
Yes, Jen.
Rolling.
Carrie Graverson, our next guest tonight.
Hello.
And where are you from?
Happy to be here. I am from Queens.
Another one.
Just
from
like
Queens.
Lisa. But I used to date a guy from Staten Island, so. I have a little Staten Island in me.
Yeah. Staten Island.
Nice. See you perform.
I'm going to be at QED in Astoria, Queens on August 20th. It's a great venue, so I'm trying to get people out there.
But well, you ain't going to get them from over here.
No. Hop on the ferry. It's just a bridge or a ferry right away.
Fred's like, I'm not going to be there.
What's your favorite comic?
Right now, I'm pretty big on Jim Gaffigan because he has this new show on.
Me too.
He's rocking out.
All right, so let's hear your stuff.
All right, thanks.
Yeah. All right, well,
yeah.
Staten Island. So this is a party town, right? You guys like to party a lot?
Woo-hoo. Yeah.
Have any of you ever been to a mustache party?
No.
So a mustache party, for those of you who don't know, is where everybody in attendance has to wear a mustache. And I hosted a mustache party, and I had to buy mustaches for people who can't grow their own. And that's women under 65 of non-Mediterranean descent.
Oh,
right?
Man. That's messed up.
So I went to the party supply store, and I walked in, and I said, excuse me, do you sell mustaches? And the girl who worked there said, I think we sell fake ones.
Wow.
It's like, I will take those then. If that's all you got. That'll be fine. So dating is difficult. I was out of the dating game for a long time, and I recently went back into it. And I was in a bar, and I saw a guy there. that was so smoking hot. It was, I mean, just unbelievably hot. Almost as hot as Bob, as bodybuilder Bob.
And, thank you very much.
And we started chatting. We started talking, and I'm flirting with him, and I'm doing great. I'm flipping my hair. I'm, like, touching his arm, doing well. And finally I say, what do you do for a living? And he says, I'm a sanitation worker, which is fine. That's cool. I don't bat an eye, right? These are necessary jobs. He's in a union. He's employed. He has a good upper body. Like, it's fine. But he goes, I'm a sanitation worker. And then he looks me up and down, and he goes, so I'm used to picking up trash.
Oh.
Harsh, right? And I said, did you just admit that you're picking me up? Still got it. Not sweating it. Still got it. I like Tinder. I like Tinder because you can meet someone very quickly. You can set up like multiple dates in one night, right? I try to do 3 dates in one night.
Oh my God.
Or I have like dinner with one guy and then like dessert with another guy and drinks with the third guy. Just kidding, it's all drinks. I have a problem. Because I feel like you can tell very quickly if you have chemistry with someone, right?
Yeah.
If you're sitting across the table, you can tell like almost immediately. So I'm sitting there on a Tinder date, and I say to the guy, I give a reference, he doesn't answer. So I say, are you a fan of The Simpsons? And if I had asked any of you that, you would have said, possibly yes, possibly no. What I wasn't expecting was for him to say, do you mean the cartoon?
Wow.
No, I'm glad you clarified, because when I say, are you a fan of The Simpsons, I mean Ashley, OJ, and Jessica Simpsons, not the cartoon that's been on the air for 30 years. Like, that wouldn't do it for me. I don't know if it's a surprise to anyone that my parents are divorced. But my parents are divorced. My mom is remarried, which means I have a stepdad, and he is awesome but a little quirky. We went out to dinner one time, and I ordered calamari, and I offered him some. I said, Ed, would you like some calamari? And without missing a beat, as if it had been on his mind forever, he just said, calamari tastes like condoms. Right? There's a natural follow-up question to that comment, right? I think are we all thinking it?
Yeah. Yes.
When were you eating condoms? And the condoms that you were eating, were they battered and fried and dipped in marinara sauce? Because I would probably eat that. I pretty much eat anything battered and fried. I would eat my own foot if it were battered and fried. I would eat that drum if it were battered and fried. I would eat you, Freddie, if you were battered and fried.
Woo!
That got weird.
Oh, yeah.
So... That was me trying to flirt. That's me being flirty. That's as bad. It's a low bar for that. I'll end on this. I couldn't find a greeting card for my stepdad when he had a birthday. I just needed a card that said, dear stepdad, happy birthday. That's all I needed it to say, and I couldn't find one. So I had to write my own. And if you have a stepdad, let me know if you'd like to buy this card. But on the outside it says, dear stepdad, we don't share any of the same DNA. And then you open it and it says, but we've both spent some time inside mom. Oh. Happy birthday. Thank you so much for having me. Enjoy the rest of your night.
Gotcha. Oh, no.
That was amazing.
So
we're going to move right along, because we got all this energy tonight.
Yes.
We're going to really put it out there in Staten Island.
You were going to say the joke about the king of the...
The joke?
Oh.
Oh. You know, well, Natalie's going up now, so...
No, I know.
Pretty.
No.
So, anyway.
Anyway.
Yeah, that was a good segue.
Yeah, that was nice.
Anyway, we got Natalie
Peri.
Hey.
Miranda, Jen, Francesca, Angela. Natalie Peri's coming on again to do another song.
I'm very excited.
On to Staten Island Comedy Show.
Yes.
So there you go.
Here we go. Woo-hoo. All right.
Natalie Peri. Woo!
Yeah.
Running. Running just as fast as you can. Running. Running just as fast as you can.
Miranda, Jen, Francesca, Angela.
Like, hey, how you doing?
Awesome, hey. So Angela.
Yes, Nevin.
And beautiful co-host.
Yes, co-host.
Okay. Hey, did you hear about why the fly was on the toilet seat?
No. Why?
Because he got pissed off. I just came to mind for some reason.
Good timing, Angela. Good timing.
Just for some reason.
So anyway, moving
right along.
Go to the end of the line.
Okay, so now we have Frank Cintula. Hi, how are you?
Good.
Good, we're very happy that you're here on the show today. Are you from Staten Island?
Yes.
Yes? What part?
I'm from the southern part.
That's nice. Do you have any upcoming shows that we can attend?
Oh, you want to go?
Yeah. I'll go, yeah.
Well, I'm doing the Carolines on Broadway.
Okay.
On the 24th.
Okay, so we have a lot of shows on the 24th.
Go.
Yeah.
And then I'm doing the Taj Mahal.
Taj Mahal?
And, you know, Atlantic City.
Atlantic City, yeah.
Wow,
yay.
Taj.
You got a lot of
for
chips.
For you.
I was going to say in India? Or no, I'm just kidding.
And I don't know what dates those are, but.
All right, well, I'll try to look them up if anything.
Try to get there.
Yeah, we'll try to get there.
You're going to add me on Facebook and find it all out.
Facebook? Okay,
yeah.
So that's where we can get you from? Are you on any other websites or?
Yeah. Just Facebook.
Just Facebook? Okay. And who's your favorite comedian?
My favorite is probably Woody.
Woody? Okay. Yeah, he's good.
He's a great. Okay. So you got some stuff for us?
Oh, Yeah.
All right, cool.
Anybody want to hear some jokes?
Yeah! Nah.
what's your favorite part of the woman?
Oh my God.
Her mind?
We got her mind.
Her eyes.
Her eyes.
Her hand.
You want to know what mine is?
Sure.
Yeah.
Boobies.
Did she kill the joke?
it's the cottage cheese.
Oh. Oh God. What? Ew.
I love me some cottage cheese. So tattoos are really big nowadays.
How big are they?
Well, you see a lot of girls.
I can't.
You see a lot of girls getting tattoos in weird places. I saw this one girl. She got a tattoo on her inner thigh of a big black veiny hairy panda there. I'm
What? Nice, right, keeping it clean, Nev.
Yeah.
Keeping it clean.
Is it weird that my hard on is 3 inches?
Oh my God!
You got me it.
But
yeah, the queen went out. Not queen anymore.
But but my soft on is 7. Is that weird?
Oh my God!
So I went to anybody go to a strip club?
No. A lot of people are quiet around here.
I went to a strip club once and I got one of them lap dances there. And I came in my pants there.
Oh my God.
Rawhide.
But then the stripper, she said that's $20.
Oh no.
So it's basically a $20 cum stain there, I mean.
Oh my God.
I asked this girl to sit on my face.
Oh my, this is tight.
Wow. Oh. So she sat on my face, but I couldn't breathe. So I yelled at her. I said, "Get off me!" But she couldn't hear me. So I just sort of pushed her off me. And she flew out the window and she died.
Oh my God! Jesus. Okay, okay.
So I was making love with a girl, and she told me that she liked it really rough there. So I said okay. So I spanked her as you do.
As you do.
And she was bored by this. She was bored by the spanking. So I said okay. I'll take it up a notch. I whipped her. I whipped her against her bottom.
Bottom.
And she was still bored by this. So I said okay. I'll take it up one more notch. I hit her with a rock. And she had no more complaints after that, I mean.
Wow.
I don't know.
That was a shocker.
That was great.
You have entered.
I don't know.
The
I don't
Staten
really
Island Comedy
talk about
Show.
It.
Well, I'll tell you one thing.
I don't want to talk about it.
Nevin, I'll tell you one thing. His timing was good.
I know. It was.
That was great.
I didn't stop laughing the whole time. I did not stop laughing. We made too much eye contact, too.
And he mentioned Miranda.
No. He did?
Oh, leave Miranda alone.
Are you the panda?
Stop that, right?
Oh, the panda, yeah, yeah.
Panda, right? I was about to say, when?
Yeah, I think he knows you from somewhere, Miranda.
I was like, when was I mentioned?
Like, no.
Yeah. You know, spanking and everything, I'm like, I wasn't there. I don't know.
Yes. Wait, I used to think about this for once. Like,
I was like, I don't remember that.
Move right along.
Oh, Miranda, Jen, Francesca, Angela.
Whoever's going to follow that.
Yeah.
Oh, Freddy.
Okay. All right.
Moving right along.
All right.
Let's go.
We have Maureen Wojciechowski. Yes. All right.
Yay.
Good shot. Yeah. Hello, Maureen.
Yeah.
How are you?
Very good.
Oh, good. That's good to hear. I'm glad. I am. Where are you from, Maureen?
I am from Staten Island.
All right.
Staten Island.
Good.
Nice.
Staten Island. So, how long have you been doing comedy, Maureen?
5 months.
5 months? Wow. We're breaking tonight.
Breaking
wow. We're really.
We don't hold back.
We don't hold back here. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Learn that.
We're just saddling them up and riding them out.
They don't call it public.
Wait a minute.
So, where are you going to be performing? Do you have like a regular gig going on or?
Now you asked it too much, Angela.
I know. I gotta roll it back in.
This Wednesday I'll be at Eastville Comedy Club, and then the 20th I'll be at Looney Bin.
The Looney Bin.
Oh.
Great.
Looney
okay.
Bin.
And do you have a Facebook?
I'm on Facebook.
You
it's
are.
Just my name.
Just the whole thing.
All 20 letters.
20 letters. Okay. Okay. We got it. All right. And who's your favorite comedian?
Andy Kaufman.
Really? Yes. Very nice. I'm very excited, Nevin, all the female comics we have.
Yeah. I know. Yeah, it's really, just like, you know.
It's really good. Really. And like, yeah, really relatable.
Yeah. Right?
This is exciting.
Yeah. Give it up for the ladies.
Bob and Fred, this is not no sausage party, right?
No.
Oh, my God.
I can't. I love you so much. Nice. All right, Maureen. Well, do you have some material for us?
Yeah.
All right. Let's go. All
right. Okay. So everybody I know is breaking up, and they always call me for advice, and I'm the worst person to call for advice because I have no coping skills whatsoever, so I am the worst person to call for, like, sympathy. I will give you revenge tactics because I probably hate your ex more than you do. I have sent hookers from Backpage.com to, like, my kid's dad's house, except they weren't, like, the high-end hookers. They were the ones that were wearing the fishnet dress that was probably used to catch fish. I found a website online where you can anonymously mail animal excrement, and you get to pick what animal it was, and the choice was elephant, cow, or gorilla. For 2 gallons of elephant excrement was the best $20 I ever spent. My favorite coping mechanism for revenge is a glitter bomb, where you fill an envelope with glitter and you mail it to the recipient.
Yes.
And when they open it, it flies all over their house. And there's no, like, prevention for that sort of thing. It's not like you can protect yourself from the herpes of the art world.
Oh my God.
Because you can clean your house from top to bottom, and like 10 months later there's a breakout where you find a little sparkly reminder that I hate you. So I'm also on Tinder, because as great as I am with coping, I make terrible decisions. I can't date people from bars anymore, because the last person that I brought home from a bar ends up was my camp counselor from when I was a kid, but not in a to catch a predator sort of way. I didn't get a transcript or cookies or Chris Hansen. I ended up with crabs. So I'm on Tinder, and I had to learn a whole new language when it comes to Tinder. I learned that a unicorn is a woman that is looking for a threesome. I thought a unicorn was a mythical creature that could stab you with its face. There's plenty of people in quote unquote open relationships looking for a side piece. If you ask me for about side pieces, I will just ask for onion rings. And I told my mom that I was dating people online, and she didn't really take it well. She was like, well, you know, people lie about who they really are, and what if they're a murderer? So I had to come back with a response of, I already looked into it, that the worst person I could meet online is not a murderer, it's a cannibal.
Oh my God.
And that the cannibal cop is single, and I kind of want to have dinner with him, just not as the main ingredient, though.
Oh. Oh,
so on Tinder, I've met a lot of actors and reality show losers. And at this point, I have had sex with so many actors that my vagina is now a card-carrying member of the Screen Actors Guild, and it's now presently on strike. Thank you so much.
That was great. That was great, Angela.
I love this show.
The Staten Island Comedy Show. Now we're going to change it up a little bit.
Change it up. We're going to stir the pot a little bit.
So we have something that you got going.
Yes.
And it's something about a couple of short movies.
Yes. Okay. Here we have Artem Kulakov, correct?
Thanks for pronouncing it right. Thank you.
Jason Saul. Yep. And I have Iorgo Papoutsas.
Yeah.
Yay! And we worked on a project called Shattered Beauty. If you'd like to talk about it and give us a little background on it, he was the director of the independent film that we just did.
Well, first of all, I just want to say thank you so much for having us here.
Yes.
It's an amazing opportunity. It's so awesome to be in Staten Island. I'm actually from very far away. I'm from Russia. but it's so amazing being a person from another country to be in New York and meet so many great people. And being here is, like, amazing. So many American, you know, Italians and just, like, wow. This short film that we did, it was part of a competition. We had to make it in 72 hours. We were given 72 hours to write, shoot, edit, put the whole thing to cast. It was an amazing trip. The organization that puts this yearly competition together is called Asian American Film Lab. Mm-hmm. It's a nonprofit. Their main focus is to promote diversity in film and television. They work with all kinds of people, not just Asian Americans, mm-hmm. but not just this guy right here.
I wish.
They also focus a lot on women equality and just diversity in general. It's a very good organization.
Great. Well, what we did, it was, the film was called Shattered Beauty.
Yeah.
And we had 72 hours to complete it. And I was cast as the leading lady along with Jason Saul, correct?
Yep.
Now, Jason, how long have you been acting?
Full time, I've been doing it just over 3 years.
Oh, that's great. Yeah.
Prior to that, I was in the corporate world for 8 years, just working for the man. But. Acting was the.
Now your passion is
the passion. I just went for it. Moved to New York and. You know, here I am today on the Staten Island Comedy Show.
Yeah. And down at the end, we have Iorgo, who was, if it wasn't for him, and also for Freddie, us meeting together, he called me. He says, Angela, can you be here in, like, an hour?
Like, oh, boy.
I'll be right there.
Oh, boy.
It's a whole different show.
whole different show. But
yeah, but it was very worthy, actually. I'm very happy with the whole team. And the result was amazing. And I had to say that I was meeting also, talking with Artem. I worked with him like a long time ago too, different project. But when he told me about this project, I said, yes, let's do it. And then to collaborate with that and to have you guys was amazing.
Yes, we actually, Stigna, correct?
Stigna.
Stigna, she won an award. Correct?
Yeah, our film got 2 awards.
Yes.
We got Best Cinematography, and we got Audience Choice Award.
Audience Choice!
The Staten Island Comedy Show, we got an award too, Angela. You know what it was?
What was it?
It was the Bottom Feeder Award.
Yeah. Well,
And you know, Angela, I was in a movie too, you know.
You were, Nevin.
You can't just hog the whole thing.
You're right. I'm sorry. What was the name of the project?
The name of the film was Broken Arm.
Really? What part did you play?
I played in the cast.
Well, Artem, do you have any other future projects that you're going to be working on in the future?
Yes, actually, the thing that's on the table right now is another project between me and Iorgo and another friend of ours. Her name is Dagmar. Iorgo and Dagmar have been writing short one-act plays that have been putting on stage at Cornelia Street Cafe for the past few years.
Yes, Iorgo just had a show, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Very nice. Congratulations.
So we're working on turning them into short films.
Wonderful. Okay. Great. Okay, well, thank you so much for coming, and we're very excited to have you here.
Thanks so much for having us.
Congratulations to us, Jay. Audience Choice, Shattered Beauty. And Jason, thank you for coming, and I hope you pursue your acting.
Where can they see the film? What is it about?
The film is on YouTube. If you wanted to Google in 72-hour shootout by Asian American Film Lab, you can actually see all the films, the top 10, and actually top 40 films that were presented this year.
Wow.
Do you want to tell a bit about the story of the film? Like, what is it about?
Well, the story of the film, I'm a cab driver, and pretty much I deal with a lot of issues in life, paying bills and things of that nature. And Angelina, she was one of my customers, and she was being very, I don't know, tough to deal with. And, but long story short, you know, she's very tough to deal with, but at the end of the day, she has her own personal issues and problems. And
it's not a maker.
Yeah, and so, you know, if you watch the film, you don't really know how it really ends, because...
To be continued.
It's kind of to be continued.
Yes,
so.
To be continued.
Okay, all right.
Thank you, guys.
All right, thank you, guys, and we have another comic coming up.
We do, another comic?
Now, Miranda Panda. Right. Now, are you doing any modeling around town?
I've been doing a lot of promotional modeling lately. I've been doing mainly with Georgie and Martin Miller's Gin and a few other liquor companies. So we go around, we do tastings, we do like events and stuff. And I was also in a film with Freddie. and a few other things. Obviously, Staten Island Comedy Show. Me and Fred are probably going to do the football picks again soon.
Now, I heard you did a music video, the running song.
Oh, yeah, the running song, too. Yeah, we did the running song. I was just in another music video yesterday for Gold Link. He's like an up-and-coming rapper, and we did a whole like dance party scene and everything. So that was really fun. Yeah.
Oh, great. Mm-hmm. And Jen, you did the health and fitness show, right?
Yep.
Oh, great. Yeah, we had a lot of fun. I was watching it on TV. We're lifting the chair and everything.
Yeah.
Really getting into it. Here.
That one was great.
These people have dumbbells. Everyone has a chair at home.
Yeah,
so.
It's great.
It's relatable. You know, gotta be relatable.
And Brian, one of our volunteers, lost a ton of weight.
That's my gosh.
It's proud of
thanks.
Him.
He
was just thanks. Picking up Ryan.
Good job, Ryan! Love you, Brian.
And Francesca, are you doing any projects? Or?
Yes, I have. Brian, I'm doing like a billion things always, but I have this one show. You guys should check it out. It's Crazy Cab Stories. And if you have a crazy cab story, hit me up on like Twitter, Instagram, whatever. Just Google my name and Crazy Cab Story, and it will come up. Yeah, and let me know. And you can be on it. I would love to interview you. And I go in cabs and I interview the cab drivers and I get their stories. But I go on the streets of Manhattan and I do like a woman on the street thing and I get the crazy cab stories. So that's my latest thing. Yeah,
that's awesome.
Great. And Angela, we just heard about your short award winning.
I'm breaking into the independent film industry.
Okay, great. So we'll see you in the film festival.
Yes.
Along with, hopefully, the documentary for the Staten Island Comedy Show, if it ever comes out, Fred.
Yes, yes.
Any day now.
Hey, hurry up, I turned 70.
And, trying to get it out before Bob.
And bodybuilder Bob, you're 70 years old now, right?
Yes, that's right.
Wow.
Yeah. Bodybuilder Bob.
Bodybuilder Bob. 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 Bodybuilder Bob. Bob. Bob.
Now, Bob, I heard you eat baby food for a supplement.
Oh, yeah, a lot of baby food and a lot of bananas.
Is there any side effects from this baby food and bananas?
Well, the baby food, I kind of cut back on it.
Oh, okay. I can see you got to cut back on it a lot more.
So now I eat a lot of bananas, but that doesn't bother me too much.
Cheetah!
And I heard you were in the armed forces.
No, that's right. I was in the Air Force.
The Air Force, okay.
I was a pilot.
A pilot?
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah. I used to take the garbage from one corner, and I used to pilot in the other corner.
All right, Bob, and thank you for coming. Like I said before, you're very Chippendale-ish.
Yes.
Outfit.
Only from 1970, like I said before.
Okay, yeah. All right. That's great.
I'm still in the calendar, but most of them dried up by
sticky there, right?
So that baby food, right?
Okay, and our final guest, Bob.
All right.
Angela, Miranda, Jen, Francesca. is Joe Romney Jr.
Yay! Hey.
Dude. All right, how's it going? Good show tonight.
Yeah, it's a great show, right? Yeah. A lot of excitement, a lot of energy.
Yeah.
Right? We're going to keep it going and stuff with you. You're always the crowd favorite here on the Staten Comedy Show.
How come I'm not in the documentary?
It's coming out.
You're going to be in it. I made the trailer.
Oh, you didn't make the trailer.
I don't know. Oh, maybe. Okay. Maybe I did. I don't know.
Well, we'll put you in there.
Okay.
You'll be definitely in there.
Thank you.
Okay. You've been on the Staten Island Comedy Show for at least 10 times.
At least.
Yes.
So, I mean, you're our headliner for the Staten Island Comedy Show.
I'm always very available.
Yeah, that's true. That's great.
I love doing this show. It's terrific.
Joe, didn't you do camera for NBC or something like that? Or behind the scenes?
Well, I stole a camera from
him. Now, do you want to tell us your favorite comic? I know the last time you said you were the favorite.
I don't like watch a lot of comedians. I like the people that I know. Like I know like J.L. Covan. He's very funny. He's just this close to making it, and he just he does so much. He does all these YouTube videos. If you ever, I don't even want to promote myself. Check out J.L. Covan on YouTube. Covan. The guy breaks his back trying to do funny stuff, and he's really funny. He does imitations. He makes up these little movies. He's terrific. So that's what I would be happy. I'm just a club comic. I do the island. I got my own show, Tic Tac Joe, now at the Hashtag Bar.
Oh, nice.
Which
nice.
Bobby Buns reopened as the was the Full Cup. He reopened it as the Hashtag Bar. Made it look very nice inside. You know, there's paper towels in the bathroom now.
Oh, great. Oh, that's a plus. Good. I'm definitely going now.
Wait until they get toilet paper. It'll really be
fun. Right.
Yeah.
That's great now.
So.
All right. That's great. So, Joe, you're going to close us out tonight?
I will do that.
Okay. Hey,
Joey!
Joey!
That was for you, Joe.
Thank you very much, Freddie.
It was Joey.
It's terrific. I went to get some money out of the ATM, and while I was waiting for the money to come out, the screen said, "Please take your cash." So now even the ATMs think I'm stupid. One time I walked away and left the money there. I caught a lot of static from people a couple months ago because I didn't put the rainbow flag on my Facebook profile picture. And I was like, why would I do that? I already got enough people think I'm gay.
Oh, no.
I saw this restaurant called Five Napkin Burger.
Yeah.
I thought, five napkins? I hope that's not all they give you, because I use like five napkins just drinking a soda. I found out that my mother is kind of racist.
Oh.
Not terribly, but just enough, you know? And like the way I thing is, when I was young, my mother was very democratic. We had pictures of Bobby Kennedy all over our house. If you don't know who Bobby Kennedy is, that's Martin Luther King's white friend. So I'm looking for the Daily News. I said, Mom, where's the Daily News? She said, I canceled it. I said, why? She said, it was getting too black.
Oh,
I said, what do you mean? She said, who is this black guy in the paper every day with a different black woman on his arm? I said, oh, my, that's the famous rapper Jay-Z, and the different black woman every day is his wife, Beyonce. Well, you got to be fair to my mother. Beyonce does look different every day. Some days she looks white. And that really pisses my mother off. So doctors over the spring completed the world's very first penis transplant. I was reading this in an article. And in the article, the doctor went on to elaborate on how he took the time to make sure the color of the penis matched that of the patient in need. The color. Like, I'm not sure if I was that patient that I would be that particular about this. I'm like, look, doc, what do I care what color it is? I'm not buying a Lexus here. Put the goddamn dick on me.
Whoa.
What, did the doctor have like a little ring like carpet swatches? You know what I mean? Check it out. I've been married twice. And my first wife suffered from alcoholism and depression, which surprised me because she wasn't that way when she met me. I wound up becoming Facebook acquainted with her through Facebook again. So now she only hates me as a friend. My second wife said if I ever told any jokes like that about her, that she would make me the world's next penis transplant patient.
Oh. What color?
I gotta stay on good terms with my wife now, because, you know, I'm never going to be able to get married again. When I met my wife, I was a good-looking guy. But, you know, now I look like a war criminal. Or worse, Billy Joel.
Oh, no.
Even though I'm from Staten Island, my wife is from England. 2.5 centuries of American independence, and I volunteered to toil under the yoke of British tyranny. Okay. So I'm a shaved head comedian. I didn't shave my head on purpose. I just got a little carried away trying to even out my sideburns. I decided to grow my hair back. It decided not to. So when I noticed I was going bald, I went to and I bought a shampoo specifically formulated to increase volume. But it only made my baldness louder. Being bald ain't the end of the world. Sure, maybe the young ladies don't look at me anymore, but when I go to bed at night, I don't have to spit my chewing gum out. All right, you guys, I'm Joe Robinson. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great show tonight.
That was awesome.
Thank you, everybody, for coming.
Great
thank you, Staten Island, for... Miranda, Jen, Francesca, Angela, Staten Island bodybuilder Bob, Fred Coscia, Nevin Cummings, Staten Island, Brooklyn, Manhattan, Queens, the country. We have sponsors to get out. We have AJC
Advisors.
And we have
to make you.
Orient the Plaza. Orient the Plaza.
The Plaza. Oriental.
Bye, everybody. See you next time.
You used to say you loved me with all of your heart. You used to say you needed me with all of your smarts. You used to cry when I would lie. So many years you would die. You're gone to leave me this way. You told me you love me in so many ways. Who has a broken heart? Who gets to play? You're gone.